Preferences are given properly with considering all aspects, and if it conveys something about national wildlife, then the NBWL meeting happens separately, wildlife board meeting happens separately, and it takes cognizance of all wildlife related factors also into consideration, and then only we give.
The task of the NBWL cannot be reduced to one, that is giving clearances. The Wildlife Protection Act mandates various duties on the NBWL, which include giving periodic status reports, advising governments on wildlife conservation policy, on new formation of new protected areas, and doing impact studies of projects on wildlife and their habitats.
An important part of the NBWL committee is that not just government officers. It mandates that it needs to have 5 people from non-governmental organizations who are from premier nature organizations like BNHS, Sanctuary and so on. And also 10 eminent conservationists who have been working in their fields and who are experts in their fields. So it is a very balanced committee which consists of people from the government role holders as well as people from the grassroots and people who are working on the ground for conservation.
And we don't see any evidence of this, nor do we see any evidence that these decisions taken are by any way benefiting wildlife. Any project allowed within a protected area needs to benefit wildlife. And I would love to know how a dam in a Panna National Park, what is its benefit to wildlife? Have projects been rejected because they harm wildlife? Have any violators who have violated conditions or who have violated environment and wildlife laws, have their approvals been not granted or taken back? I don't see evidence of any of these.
A small part of their role is to scrutinize and appraise clearances inside protected areas. But they've been meeting only to look at clearances largely. So on April 11th, they met and they cleared about 31 large proposals inside, mostly in protected areas. And each of that was appraised for about 10 minutes and that too on Zoom.
An analysis shows that less than 1% of projects within protected areas, the last of the refuges of a refuge of an endangered wildlife are rejected. Less than 1% rejected. So is the National Board of Wildlife doing its job of conserving wildlife? It's the highest policy-making, supposedly independent body mandated with this task. Is it fulfilling its task? That's the question we need to ask. That is how we measure its efficiency.
And for the figures, let me tell you, if we have sanctioned 2,200 projects in 5 years, UPA has given more permissions. Only in 2009 they gave 700 plus permissions.
It's not whether about NDA or UPA. These problems have persisted for years, and it is an issue of governance and functioning of the NBWL. The task of the National Board for Wildlife and indeed the Ministry of Environment and Forests is to conserve wildlife. Any efficiency or improvement cannot be judged or measured by the number of clearances given, by the speed in which they are given, but what has been the process of regulation. Mark my words, the task is to regulate projects, not clear projects within protected areas and their vicinity, that is its eco-sensitive zones. The decisions to allow these projects within PAs, were they taken judiciously, were their site visits, were there impact studies, cumulative impact studies that take into account various projects within and around that landscape? Did they take into account the various seasons? Were alternatives seriously considered? Was scientific opinion taken? What is the cost effectiveness of that project? Has such thinking weighed in in this decision-making process? That is how we measure the effectiveness of the National Board of Wildlife in fulfilling its mandate.
So everybody, because they have also, what is the difference? They gave it by withholding the files for 640 days. For what? That was the corruption. And here we are clearing it within 100 days and without corruption.
What the current draft EIA 2020 does is, it leaves out the role of the NBWL inside decisions taken within wildlife sanctuaries, national parks and other protected areas. And that's quite in contravention to what the Wildlife Protection Act asks for. They have to be kept in the role for any kind of decisions taken inside these spaces. And their role is that of an expert scrutiny and appraisal. Now, if their role is removed, what happens is that decisions are taken ad hoc and anything goes on in these places. When you remove a scientific and expert body such as the NBW, though their functioning has been questionable and limited, their role within the legal framework cannot be compromised. So it does that in two ways, the present EIA. What it does is, it does not require recommendations for a large number of projects from the NBWL for them to go about with it. The other thing is, all B2 projects, a whole number of red category industries and dangerous projects which have been added into B2, automatically don't require any kind of appraisal by the NBWL because they've been exempted of the general conditions. If it's a B2 project which includes expansion of national highways to various kinds of mining, to several large projects like, you know, small dams and so on, they are automatically exempted from the NBWL's recommendation, even though they may be in pristine prime protected areas.